I'm going to show you how you can connect any Python app to any Google Sheet. This is going to require setting up some things on the back end using Google Cloud Console. We're going to create a project, create some credentials, enable some APIs, and then we're going to link our service account that we've created to a Google Sheet. And then I will demonstrate to you how you can use this within any Python project to be able to connect your Python project to any Google Sheet for whatever it is that you may want to do. So we'll have a range of tutorials on the Spreadsheet Point channel showing how you can do this. And this video is essentially going to focus on this one core element that will be a common feature of anything when you want to connect Python to Google Sheets. So let's dive in right now. And the first thing we need to do is we need to head on over to the Google Cloud Console and get things set up over there. So here I am in the Google Cloud Console. So you should be logged in with the Google account you plan to use to access your Google Sheets. Once you're logged in, the first thing you need to do is you need to create a project. Now, I am already within a project called Spreadsheet Point, but if you don't have one, you would click on this here, click on New Project, head to this page and fill out the name of your project. So whatever you want that to be, you can fill that out. So maybe it's going to be something for scraping web data or automating stock data collection, whatever it is, or whatever you want to name the project, name it that, click Create. And once you've done that, will then be activated within that project. So that's the first thing. If you already have a project, feel free to use that. If you have no projects, create one to begin. Once you have created a project, the next thing we need to do is that we need to be able to enable some APIs and services for that project. And the very first one is going to be the Google Sheets API. So we can search for that in the search bar. We can click on the result. Page will load. Now, this is already going to show as enabled for me, but if it isn't enabled for you, this blue button will say enable rather than manage. But once it is enabled, you'll see this confirmation here. Once you've enabled the Google Sheets API, head on back. And now let's find the Google Drive API. Again, we'll wait for the search. Let the page load. And the same principle applies. You need to click on enable. Mine says manage because I already have it enabled. Once it's done, you'll be all set and your project now has the enabled APIs and services you need to be able to communicate between Google Sheets and Python. Excellent. So once you've done that, the next stage is we need to create some credentials via a service account. So we click on this hamburger menu over here, click on APIs and services, come down to credentials, click on credentials, and this page will then populate. And within this, you'll see I already have a service account here called tutorials at Spreadsheet Point. This is the service account that I can use for all of the tutorials that I will create on the Spreadsheet Point channel. But if you don't have a service account, you're going to need to create one. So you would click on create credentials, click service account, page will then load. Wait for the page to pop up. And once this shows here, you need to create a name for your service account. So it could be anything that you wanted. I've created tutorials, but you could create yours, whatever you like. So you could call it my service account. You can then click create and continue. Nothing else to fill out there. Again, click continue, then click done. And after that, you'll be taking back to the page we were just on. And we should hopefully see that new service account populated there. Excellent. So that's really great. So once you've created the service account, we're now getting close to completing what we need to do on the back end with Google Cloud Console. But the next stage is we need to create some credentials via a JSON file. And what we're going to do is we're going to download these and then use them with our Python project. So what do we want to do? We want to click on our service account. We then want to click on keys, add key, and create new key. We then want to leave this as a JSON, click create, and it will then download a JSON file as you can see here. Excellent. So once you have that JSON file downloaded, what I need you to do next is I need to find wherever that's downloaded. It's probably going to be a downloads directory. I need to access that file. I want you to rename it to just credentials.json. And then once you've got credentials.json, I want you to move that file to the directory where you're going to store your Python files. So for instance, for argument's sake, if I head on over to the terminal here and show you what I'm talking about, I'm inside my Spreadsheet Point directory. If I click ls to show you what's in here, you can see a credentials.json file. This is in my directory where I'm storing all of my Python files, okay? So that's all you need to do. You need to access that file in downloads, rename it to credentials.json, and move it over to your Python directory. Excellent. Right, so at this stage, we're in really good shape. We've got our JSON file. We've created our service account. Everything's looking great. What we want to do next, we want to copy this email address. So you can copy it from here, or you could go back to service accounts. Doesn't matter which page you're on. If you go here, same thing. You can click on the copy button. But we need this email, okay? This is essential. I'm actually going to copy this one from you because this is the one that I'm using. And then we're going to have to head on over to Google Sheets. And what we're doing here is essentially we're just going to create a test Google Sheet to verify that we can connect from Python to Google Sheets. You'll have to change this for each new Google Sheet that you create. So if I get on over to Google Sheet, I've got a test file here called link to Python. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on share and then going to copy in that email address. untick notify. I'm going to give it editor access, because it obviously needs to do everything on the sheet. Click on share, click share anyway, wait for this to go through. Access is updated. This Google Sheet has now given access to my service account. Excellent. We're in fantastic shape. Now we've done this, the final stage is to create some kind of Python code. Within this Python code, we're going to connect to the Google Sheet that we have here using the credentials.json file. And bear in mind that credentials.json file links to the service account. And the service account, we just gave access to this Google Sheet. So in essence, every time you create a new Google Sheet, you'll have to do the same thing where you'll have to share it with your service account. That's fine. But you can use the same credentials.json file with every Python code. You just have to make sure you change the sheet name here, which I will show you in the Python code in a moment. Okay, so hopefully you're following along with me, okay? The next stage is to head on over to Visual Studio Code. And within Visual Studio Code, I'm going to create a Python file. And this Python file is essentially going to be something you can duplicate every single time and copy into every project that you have to be able to connect from Python to Google Sheets. But before we do that, we actually need to do some installations because you may not have all of the requisite libraries installed in your Python installation. So we go back to the terminal. And what we need to install is the following. We need to pip install. We need to install gspread, which I already have. So I'll run this and it'll say it's already installed, but you would install gspread. There you go, requirement satisfied. That's fine. And what else do we need? We need to pip install oclient. Okay. And again, I've got this installed, so there's no need for me to run this, but you need to install both of these. And once you've done that, you will have all the necessary libraries ready with your Python. I'm using Python version 3.8. You could use 3.10, whichever one you like, it will all be fine. And then we go back to Visual Studio Code. And this is the final stage, really, because what we're going to do is we're going to create this code that you can use in every project. No matter what you're doing, you can use this to connect to Google Sheets. As long as you're using that same credentials file, you're going to be golden. So what am I going to do here? Well, I've got to do some imports. I'm going to start by importing gspread because I'm going to require that. Then I'm going to say from OAuth, which I say from OAuth to client.serviceAccount credentials. Okay, those are the only imports that you need. Once you've got those two, you're set. The next stage, you need to create a scope. Okay, now this scope, what does that mean? Okay, well, maybe you're unfamiliar with the concept, but basically this is going to give permissions that our script needs to interact with Google Sheets and Google Drive. So let's begin by creating a scope. Okay, so this scope variable is going to be a list. And within this, we're going to have two elements and they're going to be essentially two URLs. I'm going to have two strings. Okay, two strings. And I'm going to copy this in rather than typing them out just to make sure I don't make any errors. But I've got this string for, here we go. And that's for Google Spreadsheets. Okay. And then the next one is going to be for Google Drive. Put that in there, drop that there. And those are the two elements you need for your, okay. Now we need to create a credentials variable. And this is going to use this service account credentials class here. So we're going to go credentials, it's our new variable. We're going to say service account credentials. Then we're going to say from, and we're going to be from JSON key file name. Because we have a JSON key file. If you remember, we downloaded that. And we name that credentials.json, which is why I said you should name it to that, because then you can follow along exactly with me. And then we're going to pass in our second argument, which is our scope, which we've defined here. Great. We've now created our credentials variable, which is a credentials object. Excellent. With this, we can now pass this to the gspread.authorize method to create a client. So we're going to create our client object. We're going to use gspread. We're going to use the authorize method. And we're going to pass in our credentials, not equals. Great. So now we are authorizing access to our Google Sheet using this credentials object, which is using our credentials file, which links to our service account, and we're using this scope. So you can see how it's all knitting together. At this point, we have now created a client, and we can now create a Google Sheet object. So we can say using our client, so client.open, and then within the open method, we're going to pass in the following. We're going to say, here is the name of the sheet, which is called link Python. So we've got that. And then we can say sheet one because that's the default sheet. And now we have access to that sheet. Now, key point, every time you change your Google Sheet, change this. This is the one bit that would change whenever you put this into a new Python file. So if you've got multiple Python files, you're creating multiple Python projects, you need to change this each time you work with a new sheet. And if you're working with different sheets, you need to change this too. I'm working with the default sheet. But again, we get into the nitty-gritty of that within different tutorials. The key point is that this is duplicable for every Python file, and this is the one thing you need to make sure that you change. I'll make a comment here. I'll say, change sheet to your current sheet or your grid. Okay, so now we've got access to our sheet. what we want to do is we want to verify we can actually connect and we can do something. And I think the best way to do that is to simply fetch the first row and print it out. Now, if you recall, in our sheet, the first row just says this is some test data. So let's now fetch this. So we could create a new variable called first row. And this is simply just a way of verifying that we are able to connect. So create that there. And we've got sheet.row values. Oh, actually, because it's the top row, I think we want number one. And then print, and we're just going to say the following. First row of data, and let's make this an F string. So that's just neater. We can put in first row. We can now save this file. And the next stage is to run on over to our terminal and simply run this and see what happens. So if I run Python setup.py, I'm hoping that I'm going to print out, we're going to successfully connect to the Google Sheet. We're going to fetch data and we're going to print it out. So let's hit run. And that slight pause is while we're waiting for Google Sheets to connect. And there you go, first row of data, this is some test data, it's worked. Now, that initial pause, don't panic if that happens. If you're bearing in mind, your Python code is using these credentials from the credentials.json file to now connect to Google Sheet using the API. So sometimes API connections take a moment to initialize, but once that initialization has happened and it's fetched the data, Python will take over and it'll be very fast. And there we go, that has now worked. You have completed your setup. So let's just refresh this. Everything in here, so essentially everything in here, we could ignore this part if you wanted to. This is just verifying connection. You could comment that out if you wanted. Everything in here is what is essential. You use this in every single file that you're going to use for connecting to a Google Sheet. And the thing you need to make sure is you change this whenever you're using a new Google Sheet. Also, reminder that whenever you create a new Google Sheet, you need to share it with your service account in the same way that we did before. So make sure that you share that with your service account. Otherwise, your Python code is going to try and connect to a sheet that hasn't got access, because essentially if the sheet hasn't shared access with the service account, the Python code is going to be unable to complete its actions. So those are the only things to remember. Otherwise, hopefully you found this fairly straightforward.